Welcome to RP Hub. In this video, we'll discuss about Power Automate data table. Power Automate data table is the content which is indicating rows and column wise data. This can be also called as list or value which we are seeing here. It's in the form of table. We'll see here how we can work with Power Automate data table. We'll start with creation of the data table, then add some other data table and then merge both the data table together. So here in this video, I will walk you through how we can work with Power Automate data table. If you don't know about the Power Automate tool, or if you have just started your journey into the Power Automate, I would request you to watch my complete Power Automate playlist. And for me, I would request you hit subscribe and like button, which motivates me to create more content. Starting with the data table, I will just run this flow and show you the result, and post that we'll build it from scratch. Let me run this here. We have some informations available in one data table. Once we will insert a new data table, you can see additional informations are added. You can see here, these are the informations which is listed. But if I will show you in data table format, we have employee name, locations, department, and we have some data available. So these data are from two data table. I will show you, this is my another data table which contains just two value. And when I started creating data table one, where I was having just four rows and three columns. Now we'll show you how we can build this. Let me delete all those things and then start from scratch. First, you have to just write down here data table, click on create data table, just drag and drop here, and we will see zero rows and zero columns are available. To build the data table here, we'll add header. So my first header name will be employee name. Second, I wanted to add as location. And for adding new column, you have to just click on plus icon, where I will add department name. I wanted to make this simple. That's the reason we are going ahead with the basic step. Once we'll proceed it further, we'll understand the crucial concept of data table. Next, I wanted to add here some data. First data I wanted to add here as name, employee name as John, who is working from location London. Department will be finance. To add new row, click on this plus icon and add here Berlin, France, and then department is IT. Let's add four rows so that we have some sufficient amount of data to work on it. Next item I wanted to add as Maria, Paris. Your department has admin. Other row will be Craig. Here I wanted to add Boston and department as sales. Now that's it. Our data table is ready, where we can have four rows, three columns, and here it will auto create variable name. If you want, you can modify it. Data table name, I wanted to keep this as employee list one. That becomes my first data table. Again, we'll drag and drop with another set of data table where we'll use same set of informations like employee name, then location, and finally department. This time I'll add RPA, location as Mumbai, and department is operation. Another row will be hub Delhi from India, and this set of department I wanted to include as IT. Let's save it, but here I want to modify the variable employee list 2. Now we have two data tables already. I wanted to perform some operations. Let's consider here I will add insert row into data table, where I wanted to add some rows in one of the data table. But before that, we will just drag and drop For each, here we'll iterate the value from data table 2, that is employee list 2, where I'll store into current item and then save it. Next piece of item I wanted to add as insert new row into data table. Here we'll utilize the data table as employee list 1 because here I wanted to add those informations, and new values will add as current item, whatever current item we have. So as of now, we have two data table which is going to merge, and this is going to work on iterations. This is one by one. So that's the reason we have drag and drop for each loop. And here I don't want to add before row index. I wanted to add at the end of data table, but totally depending on your preference, wherever you want, you can add it. Click on save and this will generate my code. After that, I wanted to show these informations on message box. So here we'll drag and drop display message box actions, and from here we'll add whatever information is added into employee list to be displayed. Now that's it. Let's run the flow and see how it looks. You can see here both the data tables are merged. Here first we started with first data table, which contains four rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, and second data table will contain RP hub, both the rows. So both are merged together, where we have copied informations from one data table to the other. If you wanted to have a look on employee list 2, this contains these informations, but employee list 1 got updated. You can see it here. Both got merged here. In terms of current item, you can see last item was this. So this is how we can create a data table in Power Automate, add or merge two data table value or copy one data table value into another one. That's all for today. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. Your one step might change life of other. That's the reason I'm always requesting you to share this content. Might be others can also leverage this video. Thank you for watching.